Select your heroes.
Oh, here it is. Clickety-clack down the track. It's another exciting Let's Play, and we're playing whatever the hell this says. Oh, it's Ghost in the Shell on PlayStation 1. The only good thing Ghost in the Shell has made, because that anime is fucking boring. And who are you?
Oh, it's me, XLR, and we're playing a game about robots, I think.
Yeah,
I don't know.
XLR is here.
I watched Ghost in the Shell once. I don't know what this shit is.
Me neither. I didn't watch this bullshit anime at all. I mean, honest to God, like, I watched the 1995 anime. Well, I tried to watch the 1995 anime movie, and I thought it was the most boring shit I have ever watched. And I was like, wow, Ghost in the Shell fucking sucks. But here we're playing the PlayStation 1 game, because I actually like this game.
Oh, it's a good game, apparently.
Yeah, look at these blatantly sexual cutscenes here going on. Like, it's 10 minutes.
Huh? Was Ghost in the Shell a movie or a show?
It started out as a manga, and then it got really popular when it became a movie. It was like the 90s Akira, only not as good or memorable. And then it got an anime on Adult Swim, a standalone complex, and oh yeah. Oh yes! Look, this game's rated T for teen, so apparently this was acceptable back then.
Yeah, we bought this from the movie store. We're all like, okay, give us one Ghost in the Shell game, please. With the, we're just like,
did you see that robot? He had a little chibi face.
little chibi, gotta make him cute. Gotta make him, like, put him
like,
in the t-shirts.
Fans have said that this game is more accurate to the source material, the manga. And hang on, this scene bugs me because, like, I know she's a robot, but, like, unless you watch the anime or something, you would never know she's a robot and she's naked here. And it's just like, how is this a T-rated game? Like, I've seen YouTube comments where people say, I remember I rented this game and my mom got pissed from the opening cutscene. It's like, wow. Yeah, these people couldn't play it, but here it is. Metal Gear Solid VR missions.
Yeah, I love this game.
Oh, yeah. Let's see who gets a heart attack on this game.
I beat every Metal Gear in the span of a week.
Like, zoinks, man. There's a ghost in the shell.
But real raggy.
But the crazy thing about this game is there's only about 10 minutes of 2D animated cutscenes, and surprisingly, there's an entire Laserdisc making of video on the making of the cutscenes to this game, and we were just talking over it.
Is that Lapis?
No. The blue chick? That's the Major.
It looks like Lapis, though.
She's Major Laser. She's the leader of the... Hang on, I gotta listen to the cutscene. It's probably important to the storyline or not. Human Liberation Front
claims responsibility. This game has some subtitles.
So they want to liberate us, huh?
It's in English. Although you can't hear, because XLR is not in the same room as me. We're doing this over Skype, so I got the game emulator running, I got Skype running, I got my video capture recorder running at the same time, so hopefully my laptop does not overheat and blow itself up, but this should work, and here we have it, are the Fujikomas, or something else. They're called something else in this version. Big mission.
Sure, those look like some goddamn Mega Man robots or something.
No, they're original. These are Fujikomas. They're totally not a ripoff. But look, they have a chibi face. It's because, like, apparently fans have said that this version of Ghost in the Shell is way more accurate to the manga series. Like, it's more lighter. Like, the anime movies and stuff have been way more serious, and I just couldn't get into them. But I'm thinking, like, maybe if the series was like this, I would totally be into Ghost in the Shell, because honest to God, it is fucking boring. Like, holy shit. I'm glad that shitty Scarlett Johansson movie's coming out, because it's going to be the most entertaining Ghost in the Shell thing there is, besides this game, of course.
You're playing the little robot thing that you're gonna be playing the girl.
There are disappointingly no on foot missions in this game, but
Oh really? Yeah. It's all with the robot?
Yep. All throughout the entire game, you're with this robot, and you can strafe and slide around, and the controls are very great for the PlayStation 1 era. Like, if you go back and play Tomb Raider, it's pretty shitty. Like, have you played any dated games with terrible movement, XLR?
The closest thing I can think of is the original Metal Gear, because I was forced to use the D-pad, you know? And that was weird as shit, like, okay, I can't work like this, you know?
You didn't have the, crap, hang on, sometimes going up the wall is a little weird. You didn't have the DualShock controller with the sticks?
No, the thing is, I was playing on the PS3, because I bought it off the PS3. You know, I can buy PlayStation 1 games with the PS3, right?
Oh, it's an early...
Yeah, it forces you to play with the D-pad. I'm like, oh my god, this is weird as shit.
Oh, yeah, I forgot some games were like that. You can't activate the the analog sticks were certain older games. It's not until like Ape Escape that things changed.
And then I also was playing the whatchamacallit, Spider-Man one.
Yeah.
PlayStation 1 Spider-Man.
Oh yeah, I gotta play the Spider-Man PlayStation 1 game, Spider-Man 2000.
I guess you can play when Homecoming comes out.
Yeah, Homecoming on my face. That in Spider-Man 2, the movie game. Because those are the two undeniably the best Spider-Man games. Spider-Man 2000 and Spider-Man 2, the movie game. The one based off the original Spider-Man movies.
I guess, how do you feel about a linear Spider-Man game? Like, how do you feel about the idea of that?
I feel like they kind of abandoned that idea for the longest time. Like, once Spider-Man 2 came out, every single Spider-Man game had to be like an open world sandbox, and the problem with all of those is that there was really nothing to do and they were all kind of repetitive. But like,
yeah, you start Shattered Dimensions.
Yeah, I really should look into that because I forgot that game came out. That was when they were making like a new Spider-Man game every single year.
Yeah, and they had none. It was like no movies or like, you know, or shows based off of it. It was just like,
yeah, because I like it when there's a superhero game not based off a movie or anything. It's just a superhero video game.
So you enjoy the Batman games?
Arkham Asylum.
Yeah.
Yeah. Although that reminds me, like, I thought they were gonna. I was waiting for them to make like a Dark Knight video game, and it never came out. Like, it was canceled.
Oh, there was a casino slot game.
That don't fucking count. This isn't Konami.
What? I don't know. It's a game.
It's like, oh, a pachinko machine or a shitty little app. Like, that don't count. But yeah.
Oh, we should talk about our fond memories of Ghost in the Shell.
Yeah, the Ghost, all the two episodes I watched.
our fond memories of this. I don't think I've ever. No, okay. My only confusion is this a movie or show, but I guess the movie came first and then the show.
No, it's a manga and then. Okay, gotta enter this whole.
Yeah, I know it's a manga. If it's an anime, it's like, of course, got a manga.
Well, in 1995, there was an anime movie that was released in American theaters, and it was kind of like the 90s Akira, although not as good. Akira is a better movie.
Akira is a better, yeah. Oh man, I wish Bart Akira was a real thing.
Bart Kira. Oh yeah, because someone took the manga of Bart Kira and made a huge fan project where each person draws a new panel. Like, they get the same manga of Akira and they redraw each page. A different person redraws the same page, but with Simpsons characters. And it's this big group project with different art styles. It's a cool idea. And maybe they should do that with Ghost in the Shell, so it'll be entertaining for once.
Ouch.
Look, have you seen the movie? It's fucking boring. We're not talking about the Scarlett Johansson movie. We're talking about the 95 movie. The Scarlett Johansson movie hasn't come out yet.
I haven't seen either of those movies.
Yeah. Like, it's like, wow, I can't believe I wasted like 3 hours trying to download a 1080p rip of this, and it's a fucking boring-ass film.
Oh, yeah, but 3 hours? Your internet sucks, man.
But listen to this techno bass.
This is gonna be a problem. It's like a maze in there. All units. I'm sending data on the source.
Oh man, freaking rope. Like, okay, all I'm getting is, okay, robots are kind of cool and you fight other robots, like, you know.
I think that, I think Ghost in the Shell, look, okay, what do you think Ghost in the Shell is about? Because we barely watch anything. I think it's about this okay. what do you think Ghost in the Shell is about?
It's about robots and a girl's a robot, but, like, she became sentient and she's all like, I hate all those guys who created me because I'm not really a robot. I'm a person, but you're not a person. You're a robot.
I think that's what it's about. That's roughly my estimate on what it's about. I think it's about,
I feel like we're like two kids in school and they told us to go watch a movie, but like, shit, like, hey, we didn't watch a movie. Now we're going to make shit up on the test.
Yeah, it's like, shit, we're writing a book report. Have you ever had to do that where you had to do a book report for school and you just had to like BS the fucking plot of a book?
Yeah, and I also did that. No, one thing I did, it's like, it was, I think it was Tom Sawyer. I had to write a book report on it and I was like, fuck, I'm just watching a movie.
No, watch the Simpsons episode of Tom Sawyer.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much, you know, I'm just all like, yeah, Tom Sawyer conned his way out of some bullshit. No, I watched that cat version. Do you know about the cat version
of Tom Sawyer? The cat version of Tom Sawyer?
It's like Tom Sawyer, but with cats.
What?
they're all cat, and it's animated.
Oh, is this like a shitty 90s movie, or is this something recent?
Yeah, it's 90s.
Okay, I was hoping it'd be like some sort of crap that would be on, like, you would find on Netflix, like some CG knockoff film with a cat looks like a ripoff character from Shrek.
You know what's really weird about, like, Tom Sawyer. Like, all the schools are so willing to, like, teach about Tom Sawyer, but not Huckleberry Finn.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Yeah. It's all like, yeah, and yeah, in the Tom Sawyer movie, that was, like, his best friend, right?
Yeah. Oh, I gotta go down this hole. Ah! Fuck, okay. But here comes the boss battle.
Uh-oh. Is it gonna be, like, freaking Revolver Ocelot or something?
It's a tube. I'm in this tube, and I gotta avoid these things, and I remember this gave me a lot of trouble when I was playing it earlier, and I don't know how to... I think I gotta charge up my weapons.
Oh, wait, you know what this game kind of reminds me of? Trombone, the game?
Trombone. Oh, God. Yeah. Don't go near me. Oh, no, the laser. Sorry if anyone's disoriented from watching me play this game. Oh, God, no.
Fucked. But you gotta get in sync with it. You gotta, like, you know, when it's coming towards you, gotta, like,
It's like a rhythm game without the rhythm.
Anytime I'm, like, playing, like, a fighting game, I'm like, it's like a rhythm game, guys.
It's like, just match up all the patterns and you'll be safe. No one knows how to make boss battles anymore. I'm gonna do it. I'm about to defeat the boss. Hopefully their energy's lowering low. And I can't go too close to it.
Yeah, it feels like in newer games, boss battles aren't a thing.
Okay, I stopped spinning, so if anyone's disoriented, you can look now. The game has stopped spinning. Okay. But yeah, but I think
you would agree, right?
My first real exposure to Ghost in the Shell, like, it was always 3 a.m. when it was playing, like, on Adult Swim. Like, I was playing...
Saturday nights, right?
Yeah, on midnight. Like, it was 2002 or 3 or whenever, and I was
on Saturday.
Yeah, I was just... I was playing through the Sims games, the classic Sims games, because my cousin bootlegged the entire Sims catalog, all the expansion packs or whatever on the classic Sims. And Ghost in the Shell was like a sign where it's like, okay, this is playing. Oh, God, I got to blow up all these things. I got to blow up every single one of these drums. I hate this level because you had no time. You had no time. You got to keep going. Oh, God.
Just keep like, they throw you right in. Not even like a 3-2-1 thing going.
No,
it's like,
no, there's no time. If I lose this, I'm just going to use cheat codes to pass this, because that's what I did last time. I fucking cheat coded my way through this level.
What does this level have to do with anything? Blowing up barrels? Like, what does this have to do with anything?
It's more exciting than anything that happens in Ghost in the Shell, so it's a plus already. But yeah, whenever I saw that weird CG intro for Standalone Complex, I was like, this is weird. I'm going to sleep. Fuck this. I don't want to watch this crap. This ain't Pokemon. I want to watch a good anime.
Oh, yeah. Trigun and shit, and like Inuyasha.
Although I didn't really watch much of. I don't know. Like, my cousin recorded a VHS tape full of Adult Swim shows, and Trigun was one that I watched. But I really got into Cowboy Bebop and Trigun way later when I was in my first year of college, like rediscovering Toonami and all these animes. And the reason why you see me, you know those. The ending scenes in my videos where I say I await your blank and stuff in the midway transitions, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, it was basically all doing that was because I binge watched a whole bunch of anime during college, and that was when my videos were starting up, and I was like, oh, I should do this.
So Rebel Taxi is just based on a fucking weeb.
Yeah, just weeb. Just nothing but, oh, God, I've got 27 seconds left. Where am I going?
I think the anime that kind of got me oriented into the anime world was a Soul Eater.
It's the Soul Eater. They didn't make a fucking video game over here for Soul Eater, sadly.
Oh yeah, it had a fighting game in Japan.
I think it was just like a crappy little DS beat 'em up game.
Yeah. I don't know. I feel like at this point it's like a word of law. Like, any shonen mainstream anime has to have a fighting game tie-in.
They've never released the fucking Cowboy Bebop game in America.
Neither of them. Yeah, one was like just a Star Fox ripoff, and the other one was like a kind of a beat 'em up. It's like, it had a lot of things going for it.
Yeah, it was like, come on, like, this Cowboy Bebop's popular here in America. Just release it, like, put it on like the Sony store or whatever.
Oh yeah, and also I feel like another good anime game was the Attack on Titan game for PS4.
Oh yeah, thank God that came to America.
Yeah, well, here's the thing, like, the first Attack on Titan game was like some sort of shitty 3DS one that had nothing to do with the anime.
Did that come out here?
Yeah, it did. Yep.
Okay.
It had nothing to, like, I think it was just like solo, just random missions. Like, it was just had nothing to do with the anime. But the PS4 one, the one that got on the consoles, that had to do a lot of with the anime. Like, that pretty much followed the anime.
God, no, come on, go. No, 2 seconds. No. Fuck. Mission failed.
Jeez. Jeez. Man, I didn't think the barrels had anything to do with that. I just thought it was just like, it's arcade style. You're putting your name.
Oh, yeah. Oh, crap.
Bad.
Let me bust out some cheat codes, because I don't want to do that shit again.
Oh, no. All right, kids, get out your cheat code books.
Yeah, let's hang on.
Those books.
Nobody look at the screen. I have personal information saved on here. R2, R1, square, square, up, down, square, square. There, I heard a sound. That means it works.
Click.
Okay, so we decided to use a fucking cheat codes because I don't give a shit.
Yeah, we got out of our cheat code manuals like from back in the day, you know.
Thanks, GameFX. Ooh, another cutscene.
Military arms depot was raided 2 days ago and the thief was caught on camera. Codename Zebra 27. The stolen goods and the weapons were the same.
XLR can't even hear the cutscenes right now.
I can't hear the shit.
Yeah, sorry, XLR. Only I can enjoy the cutscenes.
Can't hear this.
Yeah. Although it's cool. The cool thing is that they got the voice actors from the movie that came out in 1995. The Japanese version does not have recurring voices. They recasted everybody, but America was nice enough to bring back the original cast. Yeah, and I don't care. You know what? You, anyone watching this, y'all can watch the cutscenes online. It's your problem, not ours. You don't want to listen to our crappy commentary.
It's not a real Let's Play. It's not like we're going to do like a full LP on this shit.
I mean, are we going to finish this? I don't know. How long does it take? Will anyone care about Ghost in the Shell after that stupid movie comes out? Only time will tell. I'm sure like five people or... Oh, God, it's like a... Oh, man.
What is this, a freaking chemical side bay in Sonic?
It's like Wave Race 64, test pilot. Oh, God. Yeah, so you're stuck on this little boat and you just gotta swivel left and right.
I guess this isn't the...
Oh, fuck, it's Iron Man. I shot a fucking Gundam.
So are you saying the Marvel Cinematic Universe is entwined with this?
Might as well. I mean, like, it's Scarlett Johansson.
Oh, apparently... John Wick is entwined with the Marvel Universe.
How so?
He's an Iron Fist, apparently.
John Wick? What?
Yeah.
Keanu Reeves?
Yeah, it was either Keanu Reeves or his character, one of those.
What? Huh? Yeah. What do you mean?
I read an article about it. It was like,
there's no way Keanu Reeves would lower himself to...
I read an article that said, John Wick fans, check out Iron Fist.
Why? Like, did it say, did you actually click on the article?
Nope.
Oh, well, thanks for nothing. You didn't click on the article, but... Oh, God.
I didn't see John Wick 2 yet, so I didn't want to spoil myself.
Well, gee willikers, Double D.
It could have been a freaking spoiler for John Wick 2.
Get under the bridge that leads to South Pie Dry Island. Get out of here.
I just expect to see, like, freaking Sonic and Tails on the tornado just right next to you at this point.
I just like the idea of, like, of this character just surfing across the ocean. Oh, fuck, they're dropping bombs on this one little robot. Like, I didn't do nothing. Oh, yeah, look at him dance. Those bands will make you dance. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. It's the boss. Tenure working. Oh, they're not even aiming at me. Those stupid idiots. Oh.
How do you know they're evil, then?
Look, everyone... Just assume everybody's evil. This reminds me, like, do you ever play the original Paper Mario?
Yeah.
Okay, so you know how in every single Mario game ever, you basically had to kill all the Goombas, you see all the Koopas and whatever, but... Playing the first Paper Mario 64 put me through a weird crisis where it's like, wait a minute, I've been killing these Goombas and Koopas for years, and you mean to tell me these are just like normal people with their little towns and societies and families? It's like, what the fuck? I've been cheated and lied to. Oh, yeah.
I think the first game where I ever like had a like, I thought about what I was doing was probably Grand Theft Auto 3.
It's like, what have I become?
Because I noticed, like, in the games, like, you know, the cops don't actually come at me unless I start shooting at other people.
It's like, it's almost like this is a punishment. What?
It's like, who's the real bad guy here, then? You know,
obviously you. You're killing people.
In video games, we're taught to, like, you know, shoot first, ask questions later. But, like, in Doom, like, who's the real bad guy? He went to hell and
killed demons. There's no shame in killing demons.
But he was going to hell and doing it. He went to hell and killed, you know.
Shit, you think by killing demons you get a good spot in heaven. But no, I guess God don't condemn killing. Just.
He went to hell and did it. You know what I mean?
Apparently to God, it's okay to, it's wrong to kill demons, but it's okay to torture them for all eternity in hell. I guess that's a more acceptable thing to do.
It's like that's like if someone came in your house and fought you and you're just fighting back. It's like, the Avengers Assemble cartoon, they made a freaking joke about that. It was like, I think they attacked Dr. Doom on his own island and he was like, He's like, dude, just leave me alone. I didn't do anything
yet. Yeah,
yo.
Dr. Doom... I haven't read the comics, but I've seen videos explaining why Dr. Doom is so cool. And the weird thing, Dr. Doom is essentially... I'm probably screwing over the description, but he's basically like, you know, sort of like a dictator ruling his own country. Well, maybe not a dictator, but people love him on his own country, mostly. And
so he's doing right by his own country.
Yeah, he's obeying the laws that he created, you know?
Yeah, it's like, you know, as long as if they don't go to Doom Island and fuck with him, he's a good guy.
I don't think it was called Doom Island, but close enough.
I don't know. Doomland?
I forget. I've said the name before, but I don't remember, but... Look at this. It's like the movie, the ugly ass city from the movie, and I gotta kill this one guy in a robot suit has the balls to fight my robot suit. Oh god, where'd he go?
You know, I what I noticed? I realized like there was never really an anime game that had like that actually felt like a narrative, like cinematic game. It's always like it's like a game, but then they had an anime skin over it, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah, but there's this one Capcom game, I forget. Something's Wrath. Azura's Wrath, I think? That's...
Oh, yeah. Azura's Wrath, yep.
Not based off an anime, but it does desperately try to be like an anime.
Yeah. No, I think I read a review. It was all like, yeah, this game is pretty cool. Like, all the action scenes are great, but the one problem about the action scenes is I'm not playing them.
Yeah, oh yeah, it's nothing but quick time events and whatever. And most people know that game now by just... Crap, I gotta fight Pepsi Man. Oh, no. Ah, there. Okay, most people know that game based on the fact that that there's no ending to the game. You gotta buy the ending as DLC.
Oh yeah, that's shit.
Yeah, but in this game, all you gotta do is circle this. Most of the bosses are just circling and just strafing.
But the thing, it's like I just noticed this like about a lot of anime games. Like none of them are really games. You know what I mean?
What do you mean?
Like, none of them are really, like, cinematic masterpieces of games, you know what I mean?
There has to be one. I mean, like, the best anime game I'm aware of is, Astro Boy Omega Factory, even though that's a simple 2D platformer shooter.
But, like, here's the thing, like, I guess, like, you know, the best anime game I know of is Persona, because that's an actual game.
Oh, yeah.
But it started out as a game, though, so it's like, does it count?
A game
but
with it's anime like, elements.
I guess here's the thing. Anime games that are just solely games make the best anime games, because,
games based off animes, but not... No, I mean, games inspired by animes, but not based off one.
I feel like those make the best anime games, because, like, they're actual games. Like, like the Attack on Titan game, like, I think that's the closest thing we have to, like, a really original, like, game, you know?
Uh-huh.
Because all you're doing... Well, it's repetitive of all hell, but, I mean, it's like...
Yeah.
It's like, it's a game, like... It's a masterpiece of a game, not masterpiece, but like it's like, you know, a game. Like it's not a reskin of anything else. Like,
yeah,
you know, this one.
I mean, it only has its own functionality for its. I mean, it's such a unique control scheme. Like the closest thing you got as a comparison is maybe Spider-Man, and that's about it.
But then again, like the anime was kind of like Spider-Man, you know,
sort of the movement. Yeah.
Yeah, but it's like. This game is like a tank, pretty much a tank robot game, you know?
Yeah, it could be any tank robot game.
Yeah.
With like 10 minutes of cutscenes, which the crazy thing is the cutscenes, like there's an entire making of documentary on Laserdisc about the 2D cutscenes and none about the game itself.
Was this on Dreamcast or just PS1?
Just PS1, because if it was on Dreamcast, I'd be playing that version, because this game is very pixelated.
Very pixelated.
I wish this emulator could run at higher resolutions, but currently I'm playing on OpenEMU, a Macintosh easy-to-use emulator that plays a ton of consoles, but it's still very limited in what it could do, and I wish it could do higher resolution because the pixels are just fucking atrocious here.
Man, but don't you know anything about Let's Playing? You're not supposed to admit that you're playing on emulators.
They don't care. No one cares. There's no rules to Let's Plays it more. No, don't kill me.
You're never supposed to admit that you actually are playing on an emulator.
Oh, yeah. Blow them up. Boom. Run them down.
Run them down, too. What if that killed you?
I don't care. It's like, if I'm going down, he's going with me.
Taking him with you.
Yeah.
Chief, can we do something about the display in miles? I want it changed to kilometers.
Live with it. Just get the target.
You heard the man.
All units engage. Rookie, you lead the offense. Togusa and Bato, back him up.
I hope you enjoyed that, because you can't hear it.
Yep, I can't hear shit.
Yeah. Let's see what the next level is. Oh, wait, I think it's the driving stage. Yeah. Another on-rails mission. Oh yeah, everyone get the fuck out of my way! Oh, it's like fucking Tokyo Drift.
Tokyo Drift.
Yeah, bitch! Get away, you stupid drone. Obama's trying to take me out with his drones. Get away. You have no power to... Oh, I killed a Tron bike.
It's not Obama, it's Trump.
No, Obama still... Like, when Obama left office, like, he said, okay, I'm out of here, but I better keep my drones.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. He's out there still droning.
I think you're gonna say Obama is still president in the Ghost of the Shell video game.
Yeah, there's no rules here. For all we know, this could be one of those universes with a generic president that doesn't resemble any president, but it's like, you know who it is. They just don't say it.
Oh, I remember, I think one time I was watching a Raven Rabbits commercial, and then there was no dialogue in this commercial. Like, none of the humans were talking, and it just shows like this black guy walk on stage, and he's behind a podium and has American flag thing. It's like, yeah, that's Obama.
Like, yeah, like we couldn't afford the real Obama, but apparently Transformers 2 could afford Obama.
he was in one of the freaking clips.
Yeah, it's like, but I have to think, like, in Transformers 2, the Michael Bay formers, was that really Obama that cameoed in that movie?
I don't think so.
I want to believe.
Do you really think he'd be over here talking about some goddamn Transformers?
Look, it's possible a president would cameo in a movie. Remember Ronald Reagan and Trump when he was in Home Alone?
Well, that was before he was a president.
Well, yeah, but, you know, they should have known that he was going to be a president, you know?
Well, do you think they watched an episode of the Simpsons that predicted the future?
Like, I don't know, but, like, damn, this is awesome to be... I like going sideways because it looks like I'm fucking drifting.
These are really good level designs.
Yeah, I love the classic pixelated CG look of early PlayStation games.
Yeah, these are good levels. Like,
oh, and the level's over.
Yeah, you know what's another really weird thing about modern video games?
It's not over, it's just begun. Oh, it's the truck from Spy Hunter. Oh god, what's the good thing about what were you saying?
What weird thing about modern video games? Like, the lack of, I guess you could say, levels?
Everything's now an open world game.
Yeah, like, I guess, like, because you remember back in the day when he just, like, asked your friend, like, hey, what level are you on? And you would say...
That don't mean shit nowadays.
And then when they ask, hey, what level are you on? It's like, I don't know, I just killed a guy or something.
I'm like, I don't know, man. No one knows. I'm on part 5 of PewDiePie's Let's Play. I don't play video games, you normie.
Yeah. And then, like, I'm freaking, another weird thing is like the boss battles in modern video games. Hmm. Like, I guess what was the last like memorable boss in a modern video game?
Hmm. I don't play that many modern video games anymore.
I'm trying to think. Like, I guess the last modern video game I ever.
Yeah, fucking killed that trucker doing his job. Fuck him.
Well, he knew what he was getting. He was in cahoots with the robots.
That's what you get. Ooh,
he was in cahoots.
New information. The enemy base has been identified.
Turn command over to Bateau and return to base
pilot
with Togusa
at
once.
Roger.
Bateau, Togusa, did you hear that?
Leave it to me.
See, even more chibi faces.
It's their secret base.
I didn't know that she was piloting that shit the whole time.
Who else would be in here? The main character? I don't think so.
I thought it was remote controlled.
Look, don't quit. Well, you know, they had to put the character in this game somehow. They had to sell this game via the face of this anime girl that people want to bone to, so, you know. I don't believe
it. Is she, like, top 10 anime waifus or something?
I don't give a shit. I don't care about this character. She's a robot.
Like, you know what's a fun thing to do? Just look up anime on Google and see what's, like, the most, like, recognizable anime character. It's probably, like, Hatsune Miku or something.
Hashtag Birdview. I remember a long-ass time ago, I looked up the word Christmas, and, like, one of the first images in Google Images was an image of, like, Sakura and two other girls from Naruto in Christmas attire, and it's like, wow. This, out of this entire holiday, Google searching... fucking Christmas on Google in like 2008 or so resulted in a picture of fucking this anime crap.
Anime is ruining our lives.
Naruto was the Dragon Ball Z of its time. Like, everyone's all up on nostalgia for Dragon Ball Z, and eventually Naruto nostalgia is gonna kick in, and it's gonna kick in hard, and we're all gonna hate ourselves.
Oh, actually, one of my friends, okay, you're not gonna believe this, but one of my friends, she didn't know that Vegeta and Bulma got together.
Where has she been? having a life?
No, she said, yeah, because like the last episode, she told me she actually watched the Dragon Ball and was the episode where I think Goku fought a Frieza like for the final time.
What is this, 1994? Give it the times.
And she asked me at work, she was like, hey, did Vegeta and Bulma get together? I'm like,
what you think, lady?
I'm like, yeah.
What, you don't know about Dragon Ball? Get the fuck out of my face.
I'm all like, I'm just like, you didn't even bother to like look it up or anything?
It's like, am I your freaking Wikipedia article? I don't think so.
I don't know. It's all like, it's like, if there's an old show I haven't watched in years, you know, I at least go back.
I'm fine.
Jesus Christ. Are you piloting this shit? Are you inside that robot?
Man, if this was in VR, that would blow everyone's minds.
Oh shit, they did that with Star Wars with Rogue One for the...
Yeah, but it's... I think it's only like a mission or two, just a few missions, and that's all it is.
Oh, put it on VR. Yeah. They should do that for They should do that. They should do that for, now.
Now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I was excited for VR for, like, the PS4 Pro and stuff, and, like, ooh, Batman Arkham Asylum VR, that's gonna be awesome, and it's essentially just one big minigame collection. Oh, shit, it's the boss.
That looks like a fucking Pokemon, that one Pokemon.
That does not look like a Oh, yeah, I know what Pokemon you're talking about.
Yeah, see, I know what I'm talking about.
The big spider thing. Oh, fuck.
What was that, Digimon? No, that was Pokemon. Yeah.
No, just circle straight. That's all you need.
This is the strategy.
Yeah, that's all you got. Oh god, no, get away. Yeah. So.
You know, back in the day, like older games, they didn't like question you for like playing certain games a certain way. Like now you got achievements to worry about, to feel self-conscious about, like, oh, you beat the boss without taking one hit or something.
Yeah. Well, that's a good thing though. That's a good.
I mean,
I don't care for achievements, but I can see how that'd be beneficial.
An achievement for like, you beat the whole game with like just a pistol or something, you know?
Yeah.
Now you're self-conscious when you play the game. Like, you can't play it how you want to play.
We've got a new plan for infiltrating Aeropolis 2.
It's an underground city, right? Togusa, give us the lowdown.
A regular funhouse maze.
You got that killer instinct.